Hello and welcome to a brand new episode of The Internetters. I am Gadgetwala Papa, also known as Ankit.
And I am Gadgetwali Tapasya, also known as Tia.
And we have a special guest, Tapasya's friend. What's your name?
My name is Arya.
So cute. And how old are you, Arya?
I am 8 years old.
8 years old, so 1 year younger to Tapasya. That's great. Fantastic. Thank you for joining us on this week's episode of Internetters. So Internetters, for everyone who's watching this for the first time, is a series of videos that I make with my daughter. I'm in Bangalore. She's in Mumbai. And we do this over Zoom to talk about really good and safe and fun internet habits for our kids. Now, thanks so much for all the amazing response that you've given for last week's episode, which was on... Tapasya, what did we do last time?
We made a Christmas greeting card on Canva.
That's right. And so many people have complimented you, Tapasya, on your Canva skills. So yay! Thank you, everyone. Okay, so first, I'm going to tell you what this week's episode is about. And then we're going to ask Arya what are her favorite apps. Okay, so this week we're going to be talking about kid-friendly alternatives to some of the most popular social media apps or entertainment apps that adults use. Because we are at home and everybody, especially kids, are spending a lot more time on their screens, this becomes extremely important that they use only apps that are age-appropriate for the children to use. Okay, now... before we get into that, Arya, what are some of your favorite apps? And throughout the lockdown, what have you been using?
I am using laptops and phone, and I am drawing in laptop.
Very nice. You like drawing? And what app are you using?
I use Paint laptop. Nice.
MS Paint.
On laptop.
Cool. Very cool. And what do you like painting on MS Paint?
I love painting sceneries and all.
So cute. She likes painting sceneries. Well, next time, Arya, you have to show us some of your paintings that you've made on Paint. I'd love to check that out. And what about games or what about watching something? Do you do any of that?
I look in YouTube drawings and all.
Oh, you look for YouTube tutorials. Are you using regular YouTube? Are you using YouTube Kids?
Regular YouTube.
Aha, that is such a fantastic segue into our first recommendation on today's video, where Gadgetwali Tapasya is going to give you recommendations because these are all the apps that she suggested we make a video on. That's right. This video is being made because Tapasya said, hey, Papa, why don't we make a video on kid-friendly apps that kids should use? She's referring to herself as a kid, which is amazing. Okay. So, Tia, is using regular YouTube a good idea for children?
It's not a good idea. Because on the normal YouTube, there are inappropriate ads that aren't for kids. Yeah. And the videos are also sometimes inappropriate.
Absolutely, absolutely. So Arya, this is a small input or a suggestion for you. On your mama papa's phone or laptop, please switch to YouTube Kids, okay? YouTube Kids is a very simple one. You have to set it up and you actually have to input your birth date into that. And the parent gets a prompt. The mother or father will get a prompt from YouTube Kids and they have to authenticate or justify the sign up on the YouTube Kids account. It's a complete safe space and only kid-friendly and really fun videos or tutorial videos or fun animal videos are shown over there. Yes, Tapasya?
And there aren't any ads.
There aren't any ads and it's age-appropriate content. So till the age of 13 or 14, it is highly recommended that your kids only watch YouTube video content on YouTube Kids. There's a whole host of amazing content over there to be learning painting and amazing how to make slime and just watching cats and dogs running after each other and just really cool stuff. All right. So that takes care of YouTube, which frankly is the biggest chunk of the online activity that most kids do, right? But it's not just YouTube. A lot of kids, Tapasya and Arya's age, are also really, really wanting to get onto social media. Tapasya, what do you have to say to those people?
I don't want to get onto social media.
I didn't say you want to. Other kids your age may want to. So what do you have to say to kids your age who may want to get onto social media?
For them, it's not really safe because over there people can ask you for your address and they can ask personal questions and you wouldn't know what to do. And
And it's not the right age to do it, right? We discussed this. Now, I know you love going on road trips, right, Tapasya, with Papa? You love road trips, right? Arya, do you like road trips?
Yes.
Yes. But even if you love going on road trips, how would you react if on the next road trip, Tapasya, Arya, I gave the keys of my car to you and I said, here, drive the car? No? Would you like that?
No.
Also, I don't think your legs would reach the accelerator, right? You can just hold the steering. Another thing, your legs would reach the accelerator. You wouldn't know which gear to put. And oh my God, it will just be like a disaster, right? And we don't want that. We want to be safe and we want to have fun. Because there's a right age to do everything, especially for children. So just like that, social media has a right age as well. And social media companies and lawmakers have decided that 13 is that age. Yes, Tapasya.
YouTube and YouTube Kids, both the apps are from Google.
Correct. Good job. Well done. Nice research. Okay. So the social media apps that kids really want to get onto, like Instagram or Snapchat or TikTok or anything else, are not meant for kids under the age of 13. They should not sign up. They should not make an account. They should not be on that app looking at the content because it is not meant for children. It's as simple as that. And as parents, it is up to you to enforce this and to make sure that your children are not spending time on apps that they're not supposed to. Just the way you wouldn't let your kids drive the car on the highway, don't let them get onto these social media apps. Messenger has an alternative. Facebook launched something called Facebook Messenger for Kids. Now, the beauty of Messenger for Kids is you can set this up. You have to set this up as the parent. And the good thing is every single message or every friend request or messaging request, the notification first goes to the parent's Facebook account so that they are completely aware of what conversations are happening with who and who's saying what. Is everything making sense, Arya?
Yeah.
Are you going to go back home and tell Mama Papa about these apps? The first one is?
The first one is Kids YouTube.
YouTube Kids, absolutely right. YouTube Kids. So set that up, and for you, you should only use YouTube Kids. And the second one for messaging or chatting is?
Messenger Kids.
This has been a fun episode of Interneters. You share this video with any young parent who you think can benefit from this content. And subscribe and follow the Interneters playlist. Thanks so much for watching. Bye, ladies.
Bye. Bye. Bye.